Competition from organizations vying for one of the new medical marijuana licenses is intense. 146 applicants are hoping to bring a medical marijuana dispensary to a town near you. New Jersey's Department of Health has a little under 2 months to review their requests to run just 6 new dispensaries in the state.
Those are broken down 50 in the northern region, 45 in the central region, and 51 in the southern region.
The assistant commissioner for the state medical marijuana program says the process was rigorous, qualifications demanding.
They range from past business experience, so you know whether or not an applicant has experience either working in a regulated cannabis industry or other highly regulated industries, you know, such as healthcare or banking, those sort of things. Also looking at their ability to comply with our regulations, so things like record keeping, employee procedures.
And how they'll cultivate, manufacture, and dispense marijuana. Corporate social responsibility is another big one. Commitment and support to the local community they'll be rooted in. The state can't keep up with demand since adding 5 new categories of qualifying medical conditions, including migraines and anxiety. There are now roughly 31,000 patients in the program, compared to around 17,000 at the beginning of the year. That's according to the state health department. And every day, officials say they register another 100 patients in the program.
All eyes are on New Jersey right now in this industry. Nationwide, and even to our brothers and sisters in Canada, we're all looking to see what New Jersey is going to do. To be completely honest with you, there has not been a state yet that has passed legalization or adult use that has gotten it right.
Wanda James is a Colorado-based entrepreneur. In 2009, she became the first African-American legally licensed to sell marijuana. She says just 1% of dispensaries across the nation are minority-owned. So she applied for a license in Patterson and Trenton, hoping to bring her experience and mission for social justice here.
This is typical in the industry. And the reason why it's typical is lack of funding. You know, this is a $30 million project to be able to get off the ground.
It's the same reason longtime Trenton business owner and community advocate Tracy Syfax wants to open a dispensary. He was convicted of drug-related charges 30 years ago. His record was recently expunged, but he shudders at the thought of those making money off a drug while others serve time.
Trenton Metro can have an opportunity to change that. It can have the opportunity to give those who've been disenfranchised, those who completely are being left out of the mainstream economy, a chance to redeem themselves.
Whether or not a business involves minority groups, women, veterans in their leadership is, and whether or not they're certified as doing so, in total represents about 5% of the total overall score for an applicant. We're also, though, we weaved diversity throughout other sections.
The state already has 6 dispensaries scattered throughout. Some have argued the lengthy distances between make access tough for the elderly or disabled. This plan doubles that by awarding 2 new licenses each for the northern, central, and southern regions. The Department of Health won't say how many applicants came from within and outside of New Jersey. The winners of those 6 new licenses will be announced November 1st. In Trenton, Brianna Venosi, NJTV News.